Last two, three classes, we were talking about AC to DC converter, front end AC to DC converter with unity power factor. Okay. So, we start with how we can make use of this converter so that we can have an AC to DC converter with PWM control, and we don't have to resort to very high frequency PWM without resorting to very high frequency PWM switching, and using two converters and with the phase shifted sine and triangle modulating signals appropriately, some of the lower harmonics we could suppress. So the harmonics we could we were able to suppress was the harmonics at the FC and its sidebands, and then the harmonics at the sidebands of 2FC. And we were using an FC of around 11 times the mains. Okay. Now, then we design how the inductance we can design and the output capacitor how we can design. Then how we will go for the PWM signal, sine triangle, we have drawn all the waveforms. Then how we can draw a closed loop schematic of the whole control scheme. Then how we can design our controller. All those things we have designed with a for a particular converter input specification. Now let us see, now all the design part is over, let us say our design is correct or not. So we will go to our simulation now. So if you see here, this is our front end converter. So this is our input reference. Input reference, when we give 10 volts, we want our output voltage of 2800 volts. Okay. Now, this output we are giving a feedback here. That is, we are sensing the output DC and feedback here, and we are controlling it. So, the before coming to the whole controller, let us first see whether it is working. We'll let us start it quickly. Then we'll come to the various control box. Okay. So, here various scopes are available. This is our total DC link current. Here we can observe here. Here we can see separately output DC voltage. Here we can see the output voltage, total transformer input primary current, and the primary reference voltage. And here we can see the total output VDC means output DC voltage, then the input voltage, then the two converter due to PWM that current, and the total current. So let us start it now. Let us see whether how it works. We'll open this one. See, if you see our starting, this is the capacitor volt. This is the starting transient. It will stabilize soon. If you see here, this red line, that is this one. This is our input mains, sinusoidal representation. Then we can see the three sets of current here. This violet current, this is the total transformer input current, that is this one, and these two are the two converter currents. So if you can see the two converter currents, it has more ripple than the primary side. Okay. Another thing we should notice, that one, this power is from the source AC side to the DC side with the unit, nearly unity power factor. You see here, this nearly unity power factor, and our capacitor voltage is nearly 2800 voltage. Let us, so this I expanded, I x axis I put a some lower time scale so that I want to see the ripple and the current. Now let us see more number of cycles in a cycle. Instead of 0.2, I will make it here, apply and okay. So if you see here, see the capacitor ripple. So we have designed it for a delta V of 5%. So it is within the 5% thing, and here is the mains voltage red, and the two converter and the transformer primary current. So transformer primary current, if you see, the ripple is highly negligible. Now here I want to see quickly, I want to reverse it. Let us see whether can we do it. Simulation, I pause it. Okay. Now I will try to change the load resistance. Load resistance we have represented as a resistive load, 1 by R. This is the current feedback. So to make it regeneration load, I will make it negative. That is how we can make it the regenerative, quickly regeneration. So load is made need, apply, okay, then simulation, continue. Let us see our converter block here. What happened to this one? See, immediately it reverses. So because the same screen it has happened, see, immediately it reverses, you can see here. During the power reversal, the transient slowly it will slide down. See, there is a fluctuation in the capacitor voltage, but it stabilizes now. Now if you see here, the power flow is negative, opposites in the reverse direction, okay. Now it will stabilize soon. See, capacitor voltage is stabilized and input current also stabilized within few cycles, one or two cycles. So everything is stable, quickly power. Here if you see, it is the input voltage and currents are nearly 180 degree phase shifted. That means power flow is opposite direction. Now, so that our converter model is working. Now only fine tuning you can do so that these transients we can control it. Okay. Now let us stop this one and let us go to our model, so that a detailed study of the model, how you can model it, you will get a feel for it. As I told, so this is our constant 10 volt, that is our input reference. This in MATLAB Simulink block, you can get this block, and if you click here, the constant value we can mention here. Okay, so we can measure 10 volt. So this, why I put we can simulate the whole thing based on the actual voltages. But here, if you see, our controller will be in the real practice, it will be on the plus or minus 10 volts, plus or minus 15 voltage level. Then through the converter, we boost up the output voltage. So to get the same one-to-one correspondence with the thing, we will make the block 10 volt. And we are giving the feedback here. This feedback is taken from our VC. How we get the VC? That is this side, VDC. We will come to that one. This we will, we have taken that one, okay. From there, we will step down the voltage, that is this one, that is a kV. We will step down so that when 2800 volts comes, here it will be 10 volt. So any change in the capacitor voltage due to sudden loading or anything, it will act here. Or whenever, if you want to say 2800 volts, suppose you want to output DC only 2000, you can control this one. So correspondingly, feedback will take care of that one. But here we want a front end AC to DC, fixed DC. Now this is our PI controller. PI controller, see, P plus I. So last class, I told, we discussed about the PI controller implementation using analog circuits. There I mentioned output has to be controlled. That means, here the output, well within the, suppose it is an analog operational amplifier, well if it has to be well within the plus 12, minus 12, so to be safe, we will make it plus 10 and minus 10. So here we give the saturation limit output controller. At the same time, this is the last time we set the feedback operational amplifier to with the set values, maximum, minimum. Here, if you see here, we can set upper limit and minus limit. The block is there, so easy to for simulation. Then PI controller, that capacitor saturation I told. So here also there is a integrator called recent integrator. Here if you take integrator, saturation limit we can specify here, okay. So that we have specified here, then sum here. So because of this gain, this output can also, we should limit it. That is why this output, that is this one output is the one here, we limit to plus 10, minus 10, okay. Now there is another feedback is coming here, this is called feed forward. It is coming from the current, the output load current. See, the this PI control, this is coming from the output load current. We are putting a load for the simulation, we are putting a resistive load, okay. This output DC multiply 1 by R give the load current, again gain, current gain, we will give it here, okay. So this current gain plus this one, when it gives here, okay. So here also this gain you should properly do it so that the current total reference should be always plus or minus 10 volt level, okay. Now, if you see, this is called feed forward, but this we have not talked before. If you see here, this PA controller, we want this PA controller to change whenever only the capacitor changes, okay? Or whenever our reference change only, we want this PA controller should act. But if you see, sudden load changes, there is a fluctuation in the capacitor voltage, okay? That can load change reflect here, then it will give a required current reference. So, instead of going through this output loop, if we can sense the output current in actual practice, and then the power balance, input power is equal to output power. So, we know the input voltage, peak value, RMS value, sinusoidal, we know it, output DC is also known. So, from that one, for any sudden load change in load, what is the required input current we can feed forward it here, okay? So, that we can give it. So, this is the total current reference. This current reference, we want unity power factor. This gives the, for the sinusoidal current, what is the peak value? Now, we will generate a sine wave. This sine wave is, in actual practice, we have to derive from the mains, so that it should have the, and here we are generating with an amplitude 1. So, we want only the sine function 1 and this frequency 2 pi into 60, that is our mains frequency. Then this slight phase lead is adjusted here, as I told before, their phase lead we can adjust such that is our input mains frequency, and this due to the current, which is reference current and feedback current has to come through the current loop, and it's we are dealing with sinusoidal current, there is a delay will be there. That delay can be compensated by giving a lead to the reference here. That is what we are given. That with trial and error we can adjust it. So, that we will get nearly unity power factor, okay. So, it has come here, we are multiplying that one. So, our final current reference is here. Now, current feedback. So, if you see here, the current feedback is taken from here 1 by R, okay. This current feedback, there are two converters will give total IS1 and IS2 input current, and this is our, so two converters should equal current. So, this is the total load current. This total current we can take it and divide by the current gain and we can feed it here. Then current control loop. Controller, we said we require only a proportional gain, that is LS. Here LS is used, L is the our inductance. Then T is equal to 2TR, we know it is that K current feedback gain, G is the converter gain. So, this we can put it here. So, if you take the gain factor, we can that put this gain here, that is what is specified here, okay. So, gain is given here. Then there is a saturation limit here, okay. So, here also saturation, we are always saturation limit, we are making plus or minus 10, okay. This will come here to this one minus VG. This is coming from our VST, that is our reference voltage. So, this minus VST, VG, this one with the saturation we are giving to the converter as the input. See, here also this also acts as a feed forward. If any change in fluctuation VST happens, if it is not here, then it will reflect on the capacitor, and then capacitor will give the current, and then only current loop will adjust. Instead of that one, we can through a feed forward, we can give it here. That is from the standard, that converter equation, VST minus or VST plus L into di by dt is equal to VRT, okay. We can give it here. Now, so this is also, this is the our converter. Converter we have, if you see here, there are two converters. Okay, this input is our that VRT reference, okay. This reference is compared with the triangle waveform. So, here triangle waveform we can generate a sine, first we will generate a sine wave multiplied by that frequency is not 60 multiplied by 11. So, this is 2 pi into 660. This triangle waveform will pass through an A sine, this arc triangle trigonometric function. So, this will automatically, if you give arc sine, if you give it is a triangle waveform, which is in phase with the sine waveform. So, phase shift will not be there. So, that is why I think we want to have a triangle waveform, which is in synchronized with our mains. So, arc time it comes, you know, it will, arc tan means it is angled, you know, it will go to the pi value, plus minus pi. So, corresponding gain if you do it here, with gain multiplication you can get the triangle waveform which goes to whatever the value, plus or minus 10 or plus or minus 1, whatever we want here. Then this is the logic, we will put it here. In this logic, if you see, this output 1 for positive input, that means when the error is negative, that is sine is greater than the triangle value, or negative when the sine, that is minus 1, the sine is less than the triangle value. So this is the one we can give it here. So this, so we will get a PWM waveform. This PWM waveform going from plus 1 minus 1 multiplied by VDC by 2, that is our VDC, we know it. So VDC by 2 plus or minus 1, you will get the pole voltage, that for phase A leg, or this is phase B leg waveform here. So if you see here, this side it will only plus or minus 1 only, that is then multiplied by this one, you will get the actual voltage here. Maybe we can connect this one to the input side, and we can observe that one, whether it is working. Okay. Now let us take the axis property also. If you see here, it is going plus or minus 1. So, but you see, we are multiplying, we are taken from here. So, we have to increase the amplitude. So, here we will change the amplitude. We want minus 3000. We are plus or minus VDC by 2. So, 2800. So, we will make it as around half of that one. So, approximately 2000 and plus 2000. Now we will run the system, we will see what is happening. One leg, see, if this is the starting, so the capacitor has to build up, quickly a capacitor is building up, then the pole voltage is waveform, this is the starting transient because we initiated. So once it stabilizes, it will go into plus VDC by 2, minus VDC by 2. Okay. This is for one converter. Now we will stop this one. So same way we have the other converter here. In this converter, compared to this one, as I told before, the sine waveform, this also 2π60, and phase shift we are not, see here we are making a 180 degree phase shift at a triangle waveform, that is a phase we are given a pi given here. So compared to previous one and this one, their phase shift of 180 degree will be there. Okay. Again arctan, we will use it, this one, and with the gain you will get the triangle waveform. Maybe we can observe how this triangle waveform looks like. We will copy this one here, okay, and two waveforms maybe we can give it here. So we require a multiplier block. Okay, this is the triangle waveform we are seeing here, which are 180 degree phase shifted. Maybe we can slightly expand it so that we can see a better waveform. 0.0. See, the waveforms are opposite to each other. So this scale we will again adjust it here. So that will make it, we'll make it 20 here. So two triangle, as I told, this is for the converter 1, this for the converter 2, and this should be 180 degree phase shifted. So that is taken care, as I told here. Now let us see for the converter 2. Converter 2, we are using the triangle waveform which is 90 degree phase shifted compared to this phase A, but these two are again 180 degree phase shifted. So let us see whether this is 90 degree phase shifted. So here, if we go here, we have already the pi by 2, there is a 90 degree phase shift we are entered here. Okay. So that is true. Now let us see whether simulation it is happening there. So we will remove this block and we take this one here. So this is for, these two are for the converter 1, phase A leg, phase B leg triangle, and this for the converter 2, phase A and phase B. So this, for this converter, the triangle waveform should be 180 degree phase shifted. Okay. Should be 90 degree phase shifted now. Let us see now. See, these two are 90 degree phase shifted. And these two waveforms, so converter 1 and converter 2 triangle waveform 11 times, but 180 degree phase shifted. A and B, for converter 1 and converter 2, phase A leg is 90 degree phase shifted. That is what we are seeing it now. Okay. Now, let us stop and let us see whether these two are 180 degree. This is 90 degree and again 180 degree here. So, let us see that one. So, we will drag this one, we will delete this one from here and drag it there and then check it. So, with one scope, this this is called MUX block, with an we can multiplexing, we can two channels or three channels we can put to a scope. So, let us take this one here, okay. I will take this one here, one is here and this one here. So, let us see, this should be 180 degree phase shifted, yes. So, this is also 180 degree phase shifted. So, why you want to do this one? As I told before, these two are 180 degree phase shifted and the switching logic for this converter is interchanged. For this one, sign is greater than the triangle, top switch is on. Here the sign is greater than the triangle, bottom switch is on. Okay? So, this we can take care of this one, output input relation here by specifying here. Okay? Now, so by doing this one, all the harmonics at the FC and side of FC can be suppressed from the converter itself. So, for this converter as well as this converter, FC and its sidebands will be absent. And the sidebands at FC, 2FC and its sidebands for this converter, and the current generated due to that one, due to this converter and this converter, they are in opposite, that we saw that the ripples are opposite, so that the primary side it will get suppressed and primary will have the harmonics only at sidebands of 4FC. This simulation result will come to in the last stage after the going through this whole simulation blocks. So, this is clear, this we have understood it. Now, I will stop this one, then so this is the converter. So, converter, we will have the switches, we are here the switches are assumed as ideal. So, whenever the sign is greater than, immediately top switch is on, so plus 1 minus 1, then multiplied by VDC by 2, you will get plus VDC by 2 minus VDC by 2. So, here you will get the converter 1 and converter 2 voltages. So, slightly shifted we will see, this is the converter 1 output, this is the converter 1 output, this is the converter 2 output, these are the VRT waveforms. Let us see what is this one here. See, this is the converter output waveform here, VRT here, okay. This is the, this will show the current waveform. So, converter 1, the PWM waveform is like this, it is going to 2800 by 2 tops and minus VDC by 2, it goes. And this suddenly you see here, this is due to the capacitor fluctuation. So, we are trying to simulate as close as possible to the actual one. So, capacitor simulation, we said we are delta V of plus or minus 5%. So, we are doing that one. So, now it is stabilized. So, we have started that one. So, it is more or less constant. Okay. Now, let us see the other converter, current waveform for the converter 1. See, how to generate the current waveform here? See, current waveform we can generate, we are getting the PWM waveforms, correct? From the PWM waveforms, plus VDC to minus VDC by 2, okay, 1 by SL integral, here we will get the current waveform, okay, 1 by SL. So, this is the one, 1 by S, SL, this is the one, this way we will utilize, 1 by SL, 1 by L1 here, okay. So, here is the integral 1 by L and integral. So, while integrating we found there is a DC offset error. So, to cancel that one you get the feedback here. So, this will give the complete motor current. So, if you see here simulation converter current, it will be like this. See, this is the converter current, one converter current, because it is the starting. So, it is now slowly it will stabilize now. Okay. So starting is just starting only. So once it will stabilize, the converter current will stabilize. This is the converter current. Now, the second converter current. Second converter current will be, so this converter current is, second converter current is here. Okay, that is for the first converter, this for the second converter. So the VAB, so VR, actual VR minus VST 1 by SL, that is this one, this is the VST part, minus part. So that will give 1 by SL. So here plus or minus, that depends on how you take it. You can take it VST, VRT is equal to VST plus L into DI by DT, or the other way, whatever way you can take that, plus or minus is not important here. So this current come here. Now current we got it. So from this one, how do you find out the converter ID current? So if you see here, this converter, there are phase leg and phase B are there. So this converter current, rectified current comes at the DC side. So here we will be multiplying by the plus or minus 1 output here, plus or minus 1 output here. So if you see here, so the converter output, so plus or minus, when the top switch is on, IST will be going the other side. Okay, during the negative, when the negative side is on, if the current is negative, it will go to reflector on the other side. So the converter current, if you see here, this will be like this. So this is the converter output current, it is going negative, ripple, 0 to negative. So this is because we have made regeneration, load is negative here. So load we will make it positive here, then we will get the current flow from AC to DC side. Apply. Okay. So now if you see here the ID, see it is going to the positive side, quickly it changes. So it stands in this, very minimal. So this is the ID current. Now this ID current, these are converter 1, this is converter 2. We have only shown the total current. If you see the, if you want to see the individual current, we can switch off this one, can remove this one, individual current we can put it. Maybe two currents, individual current. See this individual current. So the pulses due to it starting. Every time we switch off and start, it is starting. So the individual current, okay, that is coming towards the ID side, that is coming out of the converter. Converter, if you say DC, and the ripple will be there. Ripple will part will go through the capacitor. And as I told, there is another frequency. See, this capacitor fluctuation, we have designed with the 2 times the input frequency. That is visible here. See this, apart from the high frequency ripple, there is a 2 times frequency is there, this current. So the capacitor ripple has to be designed for this 2 times that we have done before, not for this PW switching frequency current. This is from one converter. So this one we are giving to 1 by SC. So that will give our capacitor voltage. Then divide by 1 by R, that is our resistance. Okay. So this is the block diagram. Now let us see the primary, let us see our VS1, total current VDC and the transformer primary voltage here. This is the starting. In the starting we are assuming capacity is not charged, that is a heavy transient. So simulation we can do it. So this is the transformer primary current, this is the mains voltage, and this is the capacitance, DC link capacitor voltage. So if you here you can see it is nearly unity power factor, nearly unity power factor. Now let us see, let us reduce more number of cycles, let us bring it here so that we can, I will make it 0.3, okay, 0.1 I will make it. So more number of cycles you can see here. So this is capacitor ripple is visible here. Now I want to pause this one, pause. and I will suddenly change the load to minus. This is minus, apply, okay. Where is our screen? This is our screen, and I say simulation, continue. See, immediately power flow is reversed quickly. So this is the transient during the power flow reversal. See, quickly power flow is reversed. This is the primary current, this is the primary voltage. Okay. Now let us see the total current and total voltage here. That is here. That is this one. See, this is the one. This is the total current. We can expand and see the ripple clearly. See, doing the x axis we can do it. I will make it 0 to 10 times, we will increase it. See the ripple. As I told, see, because it is this opposition from the two converters, that makes the harmonics at the second FC, sidebands of second FC get suppressed at the primary side. So, the primary ripple will be much less, you can see here. Okay, these are the individual converter currents. Okay. Now, let us see again here, increase the scale here and see the current reversal, we can see it here. Instead of 0.02, I will make 0.1 here. Okay. So, this is the, now again sudden load change, I want to forward power flow. So, I will pause the this one, simulation, pause it, I will go to this one, change the load to positive. That is the way we are simulating the forward power flow and reverse power flow here, and simulation continue. Let us see our, see, it quickly changes, very fast change with nearly unity power factor. Previously it was reverse power flow, now it is forward power flow. See, quickly it changed. This is the, see here also, if you see here, see it has quickly changed. Here is two converter currents we show. So, this way we can, before fabricating or before final design of the converter, controller, we can tune it like this. So, our assumptions and theories are correct. Now, let us see the FFT waveforms, where it is coming out, whatever we predicted is coming. So, we will again go back to our design quickly and come to our simulation result now. So, what I have shown this one to get a feeling for you that, so all the design with the engineer approximation, using the correct engineering approximation, we can model the system, okay, find out the transfer function, and from the transfer function we can appropriate controller design, we can initiate and we can arrive at the controller. Once that controller parameter is also designed, we can go for a simulation study, and we can use the various control blocks here and we use the simulation study here, okay. So, this is the converter waveform. When the converter is positive, the current will be going through the ID. The negative side, it is the reflected one, it will come. Okay. So, this is by multiplying the plus part and minus by part, plus 1 and minus 1 by the IST current, the reflector, DC rectified current, we can get it. So, that is ID. That ID I showed you, that is this one. This ID, it has a 2 times the mains frequency component is there. So, your capacitor has to be designed for that one. Okay, we have designed the capacitor ripple also we have seen. Now, let us see again quickly go back to our FFTB, whether it is coming. Okay. So, design of the simulation front end converter. We set input voltage is equal to 1432 VRMS, last class we have seen, and output DC are 2800 volts, and the switching frequency, that is the triangle frequency, 60 into 11 times. Now, peak input voltage, that is okay, 2025 voltage, input frequency is 60 hertz, okay. Rated load current 500 amperes and assume an efficiency of 98%. Rated RMS input current we can find out, equating the input power to the output power with efficiency. So, this is the input current we can get, okay. Rated peak current is this much. Assume a modulation index, we said 0.8. We will not go to the peak value of the our modulating VRT. We do not want to go to the peak value of the triangle waveform to avoid in practical case to avoid the narrow switching pulses. So, modulation test we will only put 0.8. So, that means if 2800 volts is our output DC voltage, our VRT, that is the VAB reference maximum, we can go up to 0.8, 22240. So, that with the controller gain we have limited that one. So, maximum RMS converter input voltage, okay, then peak ripple delta V of 5%, okay, that we found 140 volts. So, this is the thing, this is the converter we have used, this is the current, this is the current. See, this current is the current coming here. The one how to get this one ID, when this switch is on, this current will come here, okay. Then these two switches are on, whatever the current coming to this left, that is if you are taking this current, the negative of that one will go here. That is why we have taken the VAB, this one, positive side, VAB positive one, negative one, multiplied by the current value, that is we are showing the rectification. We will get the ID current here. That is how two ID current we have simulated here. Then this is the capacitor. Then also we found out that the for this limb, A limb and B limb of converter one, the triangle waveform is 180 degree phase shifted and we are using the same sine wave. But the switching logic for this one is ulta. That means whenever sine is greater than the triangle, when we are switching on this one here with the 180 degree phase shifted triangle, we are switching on this one. So, for the fundamental get added and all the carrier frequency at FC and its sidebands get suppressed, cancelled. This is true here also. So, this current waveform and this current waveform will have the harmonics at two times the sideband 2FC and it appears at the sidebands of two times the carrier frequency. Now, by 90 degree phase shift between the triangle waveform of this one and this one and this one and this one, two times, so 2 into 90 approximately 180 degree. So, here these currents, the flux generated by these two current get cancelled and it will not reflected here. So, the transformer primary current, you will get only the harmonics at 4FC and its sidebands, okay. This from the simulation study we have found that one. So, now, so these are the current design, how to see the unity power factor, how to do that one. So, that we will generate the IS in phase with VS, that we have done, and we are given a slight phase lead to take care of the converter delay because we are doing the sinusoidal currents here. Now, how to design the inductance? So, this is very easy from this equation, VS is equal to VST plus the LDI by DT is equal to VRS. So, from this equation VRP is a root of, that is it is a triangle, right angle triangle. From there we can find out VR. So, LV got approximately this value here. Then, okay, converter gain G into 1 plus STR, triangle we found in a 60 times what is the time period. Okay, gain for a 10 volts, you know, it is 280, we can give that G. Then the current loop design, for a first order lag equating the thing, we got the current, we require only a simple gain loop here and the first order lag here, okay. So, we found the current response is something like this and assuming a damping factor from the control system design from the standard textbook details, for theta is equal to 0.70 sin, we can design the, we can find out the T. So, T is equal to that T initially we put it as a first order lag we want. The whole system on to refer to a first order lag, that is the equation. So, T we found it is equal to 2 TR with this damping. TR is our triangle period, okay. Then KI, current line, that gain we have found out. then this current loop, see this current loop is coming inside a voltage loop. The dynamics of the voltage loop is much slower than this one. So, all the S square terms in the current loop we can, this part, we neglect it. When we are considering this loop within the voltage loop and the current transfer function we approximated like this, that is here. Then we this one inserted into the voltage loop and go to put a PI controller. So, this is the final loop. Okay, once again I will do it. This is the reference, this is the feedback. So, final loop we get it. So, here what we have to find out the Kn and the Tn. Then we use the principle of modulus hugging, closed loop transfer function. See, the purpose of this closed loop is input should follow the output as fast as possible. So, for wide frequency range, the ratio, the modulus of the input or output by input should be equal to 1. So, how we can choose Kn and Tn such that for wide frequency range the modulus will be equal to 1. So, we studied that one and we got this equation for a, and we found this is a third order system. So, for third order system, so B 0 should be A 0 and B 1 should be A 1, one condition. So, low frequency this will become 1, then how for higher frequency we found out the modulus and got this equation should be 0. So, final transfer function with the modulus with optimization approach what we have adopted, it will be like this. From this one we found out the gains Kn and Tn equating that part. Okay. This is the one we are using in our block. The final block is like this. So, this is the one we have, this block we have used for simulation. So, this is the reference, this is the feedback, this is the voltage gain, then the PI controller we have selected the value and the PI controller has a limit plus or minus 10. Then this is the feed forward resistance. If you sense the load current, we can give a feed forward here such that any time load changes, it is not the current loop should not act, need not act while through the capacity, the output voltage loop. Because any change in the, if this is feed forward is not there, need not be, if we do, if this feed forward loop is not there, it reflects on the capacitor voltage and the correct reference comes through this one. Otherwise, quickly it can act through this way. Then we are multiplying this one with a current reference and a phase lead. Okay, current reference comes, then the current feedback. So, here two converters are there, converter 1, converter, and each converter should supply equal power and equal current. So, both currents we can add and we can take the total current. So, we do not require a two different current voltage loop. So, one current loop and the corresponding references we can feed it to the converter. So, this is the converter 1 and converter 2. So, converter minus the our input sine voltage 1 by SL will give our current waveform. This current waveform rectified through the mains, it will appear as the ID 1. ID 1 we found it has the ripple content as well as the 2 times the input frequency. Okay. This current one charged with the 1 by SC, we will get the output voltage. Okay. This output voltage will be feeding here. This is the block we have simulated here. So, that is a MATLAB block we have simulated previously. Okay. Now, so how to find out the capacitor value delta V, again from the 2 times the input frequency. So, that is why we got this value, we got approximately 5000 and we are using a standard value of 10000 here for our simulation. Okay. Then the simulation result. See, this is the one converter waveform. Okay, this is the simulation result that we have seen now. So, this is the converter voltage. If you see here, this is the ripple due to the capacitor ripple 2 times the mains frequency. So, you can see that when this frequency is not based on the our carrier frequency, PWM frequency, it is depends on the input mains frequency capacitor voltage. And see, a large scale the capacitor delta V 5% of our 2800 volts. So, this is the capacitor voltage and these are the this is the mains, this is the main waveform what is shown here, and inside this one is the large one is the current waveform, primary current, these two are the two converter current waveform. So this is power flow from the source to the load with the unity power factor, okay. So clear waveform is visible here, okay. Now this is, see, you have two converter waveform. If you observe the waveform here, measure the waveform at the converter side, that is here transformer primary. Here this waveform will be the reflected waveform from the two secondaries, okay. So what we do to get a feel for the transformer, and second harmonics will not be here. Harmonics at the harmonics at the second FC, 2FC and the sidebands will not be there. So if you see here, the primary side voltage will be like this, okay. This is the primary side voltage. Now again we are suddenly quickly we are doing the power flow reversal is there. So here quickly we pause the waveform, made the resistance negative, and how to see this Q, but in actual practice this much will not be there, but we want to show that the dynamics is very fast here. So our controller shows also our control accuracy of our controller design. See, quickly power flow reverses. So power flow changes, so there is a slight ripple in the voltage waveform. So that transient quickly settles within one or two cycles it settles here. You can, it's visible there. So this also shows our controller design accuracy, upper approach is correct, okay. Now the simulation I couldn't show because it was not quickly suddenly removing the load. So here I suddenly removed the load. If you see here, when the load is high, the ripple is high. So maximum ripple we are limiting within plus or minus 5%. Now the load current is slightly reduced, so quickly changes, so capacitor ripple also reduce, but there's transient, it quickly adjusts, so transient is very less. This also shows during transient conditions, not only power forward flow, reverse flow, our controller design approach is correct. So sudden change in load, that is also correct. Then no load operation, this one show, okay. This may be no load operation because transformer primary current will be there, magnetizing current, okay. So this is only what we show, the nearly no load means very low load operation, okay. Now let us go to the FFT. See, FFT of the current waveform IS1 converter one, if you see, you have the fundamental and the harmonics. See, 11 times it is somewhere here, that's the kind of frequency there, all the harmonics are suppressed. Then if the next higher order harmonics happens at this side, 2FC and the sidebands, okay, and 3FC also it is cancelled, then 4FC it happens. This is for converter 1, this is for the converter 2, okay, but this only amplitude, there is a phase difference is there. So that phase difference is 180 degrees. So the primary, if you go, primary current, that is suppressed. And you have the harmonic sidebands at 4FC and sidebands only. So the amplitude is much less. So this also visible from the voltage waveform, that summed voltage waveform that I showed here. See, this is the equivalent transformer voltage. That means you are summing the primary VR1 and VR2. So this is the voltage. This happened at the 4FC side only harmonics. So what is the advantage here? Even though we are using a carrier frequency of 11 FC, if it is FC, it is 11 FC somewhere here. But we could shift our high amplitude harmonics to this side, not by resorting to high frequency FT, 4 times FM. FM is here not, by properly doing a phase shifted PWM control, sine triangle PWM control. So that without resorting to high frequency PWM switching, we could suppress all the lower harmonics and the harmonic amplitudes are at high frequency side. This is the voltage. So the impedance L, line impedance by L omega is very high for this high frequency voltages. So current is highly suppressed. So you have the fundamental and the other current. So this is the simulation study. So the approach, what I want to say, instead of blindly using PE PI controller, there is a way to select the PE PI controller. That depends on the system transfer function and its order. So first you model with the simple approach as engineering model. We like the way converter we approximated as a first order lag. So same way, you arrive at the transfer function, various transfer functions, then link the blocks and get the closed loop. When the closed loop system is there, you start from the inner loop. We started from the current loop. Then from the current loop, we try to initially start with the PA controller, then try to cancel the pole zero cancellation. It was not working. Damping factor was missing. So it is any disturbance comes, system will oscillate. So we with a first order for a first order lag, how to design the controller? Then we found current loop for the symbol, because the whole system go through only the converter. That converter is represented as the first order lag. So we require a simple gain controller only required. We found that one, and our approximation is correct. That is also proven from our simulation study and the various dynamic conditions, result at the various dynamic conditions. Then we found that current loop is acting very fast and high frequency. So current loop can be approximated to a first order lag by removing the square terms, because the next we are inserting this current loop into the voltage loop where the transients are, the frequency of the current loop is much lower than the current loop response. So we were approximated as a first order lag and then form the voltage loop. Then design our PI controller for the voltage loop here. Then the whole system we model and simulated and we got the result. So this approach we can use for not only front end AC to DC converter, even for DC motor control or even for induction motor control, which we will be studying subsequently, and for our not only VBF control or our high performance drives application like vector control, we can design same approach. So when we come to that level, this design approaches we will only mention it, because already we have talked about that one. We will use the standard approaches to make use of our controller design. Okay, with this one we will stop. Now front, we have so far studied various controlled rectification, AC to DC. We have taken a DC to DC converter, then AC to DC converter with unity power factor. So now we can control the voltage. Okay, with good efficiency, good transient performance. Now, making use of this one, we can go for a DC motor speed control. Here we will be talking about the separately excited speed control. Then how the speed control of the DC motor can be controlled based on the same approach what we have used, we will study in the next few classes. Okay.